So, Jannene, if we could continue the conversation regarding what you mentioned about recent world events, mm-hmm. and perhaps recent world events being an echo of things that happened previously, of yes. The concept of history repeating itself.
Yes.
What more information can you give us to expand on what we spoke about in our last video? Because I know it is a very complex and complicated topic, and to try and condense it down is very challenging, but we've got to try.
Yeah, okay. All right, that's what we're trying to do. So I just want your viewers to know that my 24 years of research really have enabled me to decode this, and there's been other people as well. So what we're trying to say is that Jesus warned back in his day to his disciples that within a generation, terrible things were going to happen if they didn't accept him, because he had come as God's salvation. So the name Jesus comes from the name Yeshua, that's his Hebrew name, and Yeshua means Yah's salvation. So he had come to save them, not just save them from their sins, but when we're saved from sin, we're also protected. He provides us protection from our enemies. At that time, the Jews were under occupation by Rome. There were groups of people like the Zealots who wanted to fight them. And so Jesus warned that this was going to happen. Now, he warned this in 31 AD. Just before he was crucified, he made this prediction. So it did play out. The sign of his coming was seen, or the sign of this event was seen, I should say, 35 and a half years later at 66 AD. That was when the Roman army surrounded, and then 3.5 years later, the destruction arrived. First the siege at Passover, and then the destruction on the 9th of Av. The 9th of Av just happens to be the date that the Babylonian armies attacked Jerusalem, the Roman armies attacked Jerusalem. It's also the date that Hitler brought in his final solution. It's the date that Spain expelled the Jews. It's also the date that Britain expelled the Jews as well. And I just need to confirm that last one. So it is a very significant date in history, and that was the date that it happened. Now, this replay of history, these dates have all played out at the same time as well. So Jesus was crucified because he claimed to be the Son of God. When you look at the judgment scene, when he was brought before the high priest, they wanted to know, are you the Christ? Are you the Son of God? And when Jesus said, I am, that was when the high priest tore his robes, and that was what Jesus was crucified for. It wasn't anything that he had done. It was because of who he was. Now, this same event has replayed as well 35 and a half years prior. And that was the point at which not just one religion, but all Christian denominations by then had been infiltrated by Rome. We are told by the Jesuit whistleblower, Alberto Riviera, but also on that date, a particular denomination was basically did the same thing in rejecting Christ's identity as the Son of God, and chose Barabbas, you know, chose a false Christ, and we can talk about that more later, but they were the world's watchmen. And as a result, there has not been a voice in our world warning about the dangers that are posed by this power that has a real hatred of civil and religious liberty. We've been living under liberty for a number of decades and centuries now. I mean, it's very relative, but many of these liberties were fought for by Protestantism, by those protesting against oppression. And we need to continue that protest. It's very, very vital because our liberties are fast being taken away. So 35 and a half years later, after this re-crucifixion event at Passover in 1980, the same sign was seen. This time it was heralded by the tetrad of blood moons in the sky. And then exactly 3.5 years later, again, at Passover in 2019, the Pope himself, calling for the ecological conversion, said it was 3.5 years since he had been in America presenting the Laudato Si. And the world is going through that very same experience. Now, what happened when Rome attacked Jerusalem? That's the question that we need to ask. Well, we know that many of the Jews were killed prior in the siege of Jerusalem, but when Rome did finally break through and attack, about a million or so Jews were crucified, and about 100,000 of them were captured and taken away as slaves. And so I want to move into what is actually going on in 2020. So it's very interesting. If you look at the events that happened in the life of Jesus on the day he was crucified, at the third hour he was crucified, it tells us in Mark, and then at the sixth hour darkness came over all the land, and at the ninth hour Jesus died, and then just as the sun was going down, which would have been about 2 hours later, so around about the 11th hour, Joseph of Arimathea came and took his body, placed it in the tomb, and the Roman soldiers came along and they sealed the tomb with the Roman seal, and they put a contingent of soldiers, Roman soldiers, outside the tomb so that the disciples couldn't come and steal his body. And so I believe, and this is my own information, there's nobody else out there saying that, but I believe that that is the template for the year 2020, and that is explaining what they are doing and what is actually going on. There is, as I've mentioned, a depopulation agenda, and this is about to eventuate, I believe, begin in the ninth month. And we're coming up to the ninth month. We're in August right now. We've got about a week to go till September, September being the ninth month. And if I am correct on this, I believe that we're going to see massive depopulation, mega attacks on the cities around the world. Now, I wouldn't say this if there weren't warnings of this already happening. So there's people who are widely connected to the Intel community, people who are connected to US government employees who are warning that there are that they have been told they only have this month to prepare, to basically get out of the cities and to get everything they need before September, because lots of things are going to happen. There's going to be meteors, weaponized meteors hitting the earth. And that's something that I can't confirm or verify, and I can't discredit either. That I can only really report on what other people are saying. That there's going to be rise in food prices, but yeah, that cities are going to be attacked. And so I do feel it's really imperative that people comprehend this, because this is the month of death on the day that Jesus was crucified. And if this historical template is replaying and they actually know what they are doing, which they've indicated they are, then we're looking at death in the ninth month, and we're looking at the sealing in the tomb by the Roman soldiers by the 11th month. Now, there is a man out there by the name of Pastor Dana. He was shown 2020 on a calendar in 2019 in a dream. He was shown the first half, then halfway through 2020 he was shown the second half. He was shown massive problems in the ninth month. He was told to stand and pray on the calendar on the ninth month for the whole month. And in the 11th month he saw United Nations, Chinese and Russian troops in America. And I believe that we are entering a final judgment hour issue. I believe that the number of the beast is going to combine with the push for the mark of the beast in this month. And the mark of the beast, as I'll be showing in coming interviews, we have evidence is that Sunday rest is considered by the Vatican to be their mark of authority to rule the world. And so I expect that the moral revival that's taken on the coattails of the Black Lives Matter movement is about to grow legs, and along with other movements such as the return to call for Sunday rest in America, which will finalise the Vatican's plans to enforce their mark of authority so that everybody accepts it, and then they can justify their complete authority over this New World Order government. I hope that helps to cover everything. I realise it's a very dismal subject. I have some good news, so hang in there, everyone.